Now, Mrs. Lang, what are the numbers for your birthday?
12, 16, 64.
And the numbers for your anniversary, my dear?
6, 26, 84.
Ah, 6, 26. Did I hear 26? 26? Matter of fact, Mrs. Lang, weren't you married on the 27?
Yes.
Oh, so your husband picked the 26th on his own.
Objection. What's the point of this?
The point is, counselor, the point is, Your Honor, I am demonstrating that Mr. Lang is responsible for the winning ticket.
Overruled.
So, Mrs. Lang, your husband picked the 26th on his own, correct?
No.
No? Mrs. Lang, there was you. There was your husband. Could you kindly tell us who else was there that morning?
My dead father.
Excuse me?
My dead father. God rest his soul.
Quiet, please.
He came to me in a dream. Baby, he said, as he was floating out the window, you know, he had these big wings, you know, like angel wings. Oh, my God, they were the perfect color of white leather, you know? Anyway, he says, baby, it's time to go to the church. You gotta hurry up or you're gonna be late. Well, to my shock and surprise, I'm standing there in my wedding gown. So I was running down Queens Boulevard through Flatbush, even though Queens Boulevard doesn't run through Flatbush, you know. I came to the church, St. Catherine's of the Holy Lotto. And then I realized I wasn't late. I was a whole day early. My God, I wanted to die. And then my father, you know, he was there. He was standing right next to me, you know? And he says, ay, Tito, mi little girl, don't cry. Because to me, your anniversary will always be on the 26th.
Mr. Lang, have you ever purchased nail polish remover for your wife?
Quiet, please.
Nail polish remover?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a couple of times, I guess.
And you paid for it?
Sure.
Did you therefore consider it yours?
No, I guess I didn't.
Isn't it true that you forced your wife to split the ticket with Ms. Biasi?
I only said we should do the right thing.
Mr. Lang, were you wearing a gun at the time?
No, of course not.
You hit your wife, didn't you, Mr. Lang?
I never, ever,
you
ever...
are under oath, Mr. Lang.
Okay, once I grabbed her arm, but that...
No further questions.
Your witness, Counselor.
Thank you, Counselor. Now, Ms. Biasi, would you describe your financial circumstances before Mr. Lang was kind enough to offer you half of his wife's winning ticket?
I was struggling to make ends meet.
Isn't it a fact that you owed $12,000 on your MasterCard?
Well, that's because my ex-husband...
Just answer yes or no, please.
Technically, yes. But that's not because I had overspent.
And isn't it also a fact that you filed for bankruptcy on the very day that Mr. Lang offered to split the ticket with you?
Yes. But that was just fate.
Right, fate. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Really?
Let me ask you, what was your relationship with Mr. Lang at the time he offered to share his wife's ticket with you?
I'd never met him before.
Really?
yes. Really?
Well, describe your relationship with Mr. Lang today.
I love him more than anything in the whole world.
Which is why you went running off to the Plaza Hotel with him on the very day that he separated from his wife.
Objection. What is the relevancy of this?
Motivation.
What motivation? Mrs. Lang had thrown Mr. Lang out of the house. The marriage was in complete disarray.
Overruled.
Well, if you're implying what I think
Ms.
you
Biasi?
Are, well, they're trying to make me into some kind of a little gold digger or something. Him, the media.
Miss Biasi, control yourself, please.
I've worked my whole life, and finally something wonderful happened to me. I met a man who was intelligent and kind and full of compassion. Just the experience of knowing him has changed my life, and it's not because of the money. It's because he made me believe again that people were fundamentally decent, and I'll be damned if I'm gonna sit here and let some lawyer make our relationship look ugly.
Mm-hmm. Are you divorced?
No. But as soon
as... So you're married to one man and you're in love with another.
It's only because I couldn't afford to get divorced.
Well, that's convenient.
In dramatic testimony, Yvonne Biasi was depicted by Muriel Lang's attorney, C. Vernon Hale, as a gold digger and an nymphomaniac. A verdict was expected by this evening.
Has the jury reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
What say you?
We rule in favor of the plaintiff, Mrs. Muriel Lang, on all counts.
The court would like to thank the jury for its service in this difficult case.
Thank you.
The court is dismissed.
Vaughn! Vaughn!
And don't you believe that the good deeds performed by your husband and Ms. Biasi
are... Guy, this is not a press conference. The verdict is in. We're happy. Okay, that's all.
Very happy.